Brother Amr from London called earlier, and his question was about, mashallah, he's planning on performing Hajj this year. May Allah make it easy for you and accept it from you and all the pilgrims. Allahumma ameen. He's asking about what should I do before that, the preparations, and also he has some wealth, and he shared with us that he does not save his money in the bank, rather he keeps the money in his house. So what should he do with the money? We'll answer you after this call, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum. So before Hajj, and since people perform Hajj so that they complete the fifth pillar of the deen and to remit all their sins and to return home with all their sins being removed, and they become as pure as the same day they were born, that the person, in order to achieve that, you need to make sure that you settle your debts and you ask people to pardon you if there is any pending cases between you and others, whether something physical or moral, you hurt somebody's feeling, you took a property of somebody. You need to clear your record before going for Hajj. That is known as حقوقُ العباد, the rights of the human beings, the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Once you take care of this and ask people to pardon you, then inshallah, on the day of Arafah, Allah will remit and forgive the rest of your sins, and you will be as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Raja'a kayawmi waladatuhu ummuh." Will return from performing Hajj as pure as the same day that his mother gave birth to him. Okay. Also, since you have some, significant amount of money, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ma haqqu imri'in muslimin yabitu laylatayn lahu shay'un yusifi illa wasiyyatuhu maktubatun 'indahu tahta ra'sihi." Which makes it very serious command from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that if you have any significant amount of wealth, that you should not wait for a couple nights without having your will written with you to determine how would you like your wealth to be dealt with and to be dispensed after your death. That's called the wasiyya. And writing down the wasiyya is not simply because you're going for Hajj, but even if you're not going for Hajj, each one of us, if you have some money, you have to clarify to your ears that what would you like them to do with it. Maybe you are in debt, you borrowed some money that would encompass all your inheritance. Maybe this money isn't actually yours, it's an amana that somebody left it with you. Maybe you want to give a wasiyya in order to invest in a continuous charity, in a masjid, in a water fountain, or to give some of the ears. So, Brother Amr from London, anyway, you have to have your wasiyya. What would you like to do with your wealth? And if there is somebody whom you like to give a portion of your wealth after a long life, inshallah, before distributing the inheritance. And sometimes if you're living in a non-Muslim country, there is a local inheritance law which have nothing to do with the Islamic law. So you don't want your family to be blameworthy. You can divide your inheritance in your life by writing down your wish and notary public your wasiyya with an attorney and in the city hall, so that this is what you would like to do, to give the son that much, the daughter that much, your wife that much, to preserve everybody's right according to the fara'id which Allah has ordained in Surah An-Nisa and according to the Sunnah. That's perfect. And you have to do that, inshallah, whether you're going to perform Hajj or not.